Welcome to the Photography News Show, where I bring you the best and latest news in the photography industry. Coming up today, we have the Sigma 18-50mm f2.8, the Sony a7 IV, and much more. So, let's begin! Hey fellow photographers, it's Alessandro Carpentiero, travel photographer and gear expert from Italy, and I want to welcome you to episode number 24 of the Photography News Show, my weekly series all about photography gear. So if you're into that, please consider subscribing to always stay on top of the industry. So let's see what's new. Lens news. This week, Sigma has unveiled the 18-50mm f2.8 DC-DN contemporary lens, which, besides having the longest name ever, it's also the smallest and lightest f2.8 zoom lens for APS-C mirrorless cameras. Lenses of this kind are normally bulky and heavy, but Sigma has been able to create a super compact and light zoom for every occasion. When mounted on a Sony E-mount camera, the lens doesn't stick out from the body, and it has a weight of just 290 grams. If we compare it to the older 17-50mm made for APS-C cameras with a mirror, the weight has been reduced by almost 50% and the dimensions by 20%. That has been possible, of course, thanks to the smaller flange back distance in mirrorless cameras, but Sigma also had to make some compromises. For example, the 18-50mm f2.8 is not stabilized, but in my opinion, this is not a deal breaker, given both the wide aperture and the fact that most cameras now have in-body stabilization. Sigma also had to make a slight sacrifice on the wide end, starting from 18mm. This means that the equivalent focal length on a full-frame camera is 27-75mm. Not too wide, but still, it's a very versatile focal range for different photography genres, such as landscape, street, portraits, and events. It's also suitable for some close-up photography, thanks to the minimum focus distance of 12.1 cm. Talking of focus, the autofocus is compatible with all the latest features, including eye tracking. Sigma provided several sample images from which we can see the lens has good performance, and it can be an upgrade for your APS-C kit lens so that you can have a constant wide aperture. If you want to evaluate the sample images, I'll leave a link in the description. And besides photos, this 18-50mm can be interesting for videos too. Being so light and compact, it's comfortable to mount on a gimbal, and you can actually use this lens in super 35mm video format on a full-frame camera for a very light kit. It's available for Sony E and L mount, and you can pre-order it for $549. In last week's show, I talked to you about a lens that was only announced in Thailand, and this week it has been announced worldwide. I'm talking about the Samyang 24-70mm f2.8 FE, designed to be a versatile full-frame zoom at a decent price, specifically $999. The particularity of this lens is the fact that it's a parfocal lens, meaning that the focus position doesn't change even when you're zooming in or out, increasing its usability both for photography and videography. Camera news. I've talked about the rumors of these cameras for so many episodes, and it has finally been unveiled. I'm talking about the Sony Alpha 7 IV, the evolution of the super successful Alpha 7 III. The a7 III was a well-rounded camera, suited for both photography and videography, with great autofocus too, and that was the reason behind its success. The new a7 IV brings improvement in basically every aspect, making it a true hybrid full-frame camera. Imagine taking the a7 R4, the a7 S3, mix them together, dial down some features, and there you have the a7 IV. It has a newly developed 33-megapixel sensor with a dynamic range of 15 stops and a whopping 94% of coverage for autofocus with 759 AF points. The real-time eye autofocus for people has been improved by 30%, and the camera can also now track animals and birds. That, together with a burst rate of up to 10 FPS and a continuous shooting of 828 RAW plus JPEGs, makes the a7 IV suitable for virtually any kind of photography. While talking about videos, it films 4K up to 60p in Super 35 mode, and Full HD up to 120p. The video quality is in 10-bit 422 up to 600 megabits in 4K from 7K oversampling. Color profile-wise, it comes with S-Cinetone as well as S-Log3 and S-Gamut3 for optimized color grading, maintaining the 15 stops of dynamic range. The autofocus capabilities are the same for videos too, so basically the whole sensor is covered, and there's real-time eye autofocus for humans, animals and birds. Something interesting for video shooters is the breathing compensation, which helps minimize the focus breathing of some lenses. Lastly, the 5.5 on-sensor stabilization helps have stable footage and sharp images. We can definitely see this is a hybrid camera, and this is also reflected on the body, where there is a very convenient switch below the mode switch, which allows you to quickly change between photos and videos. When you change the modes, basically the camera remaps all the buttons and adjusts the screen data to reflect the mode you're in, facilitating your shooting operations. If you shoot both photos and videos, this dial will be very convenient. And talking about convenience, Sony has finally enabled the shutter to cover the sensor when the camera is off, which will greatly reduce the amount of dust that can hit the sensor when changing lenses. The body only can be pre-ordered for $2,498, while the kit version with the 28-70mm comes at $200 more. This camera surely doesn't come cheap, but if you need to shoot both photos and videos, this can be all you need. This actually leads me to the question of the week. If you could only choose one of Sony A7 cameras, which one would you get? The A7 IV, A7S III or A7R IV? Let me know in the comments. Personally, as I do more photography than videography and I love working with massive files, I would pick the A7R IV. While the other camera news of the week comes from Nikon, which has shared the third teaser video about the upcoming Z9, and it gives some hints of its tracking capabilities. In fact, we see the camera tracking all sorts of subjects, motorbikes, athletes, and cars. In the video, you can also hear the burst, which seems to be around 20 frames per second. The camera should be announced soon, and I'm really curious to see how it will compare to the EOS R3 and the Alpha 1. App news. Instagram has finally made it possible for everyone to post photos directly from computers. You just have to open up Instagram on your browser and you'll see a plus icon at the top. After clicking on it, you can select the photo you want to upload, crop it, edit if needed, write your caption and post it. I honestly don't understand why it took them this long to implement such a basic feature, but I guess they were too busy copying features from other apps. Talking about apps, I have some good news for you if you have the Adobe Photography plan. In fact, Adobe will soon include Premiere Rush and Photoshop Express in that $10 per month plan. These two apps are simplified versions respectively of Premiere Pro and Photoshop, and can be useful if you need to do some simple edits to your content. Pictures of the week. In this segment, I feature the most interesting pictures I've seen on the web. This week, we have the winners of the Close-Up Photographer of the Year. The overall winning shot is a photo of bugs caught in a lamp, an interesting choice from the jury. Some of the shots I've selected for you are a 20-second exposure of a spider, fungi grown directly on an autumn leaf, an octopus hidden in an empty shell, and a cockroach in the middle of a bracket fungus releasing spores. As usual, you can see all the winning shots and read their stories from the link in the description. That's it for today. I really hope you've enjoyed this episode of the Photography News Show. Which news did you like the most? Just let me know in the comments below. If you've liked this video, please give it a big thumb up, subscribe to the channel and activate the notification bell, and share this video with your photography friends. And if you want to improve your photography, mindset and productivity, feel free to DM me on Instagram or send me an email, and I will be happy to help. So, thanks a lot for watching, and I'll see you in the next one!